Good morning, everybody. Mrs. Van Pelt here. Today is Thursday, and here is our quote for the day. It says, success doesn't just find you. You have to go out and get it. Right. You guys have been doing a really great job getting all your work done, making sure you're successful. Only a couple more weeks left of school. If you're joining us for summer session, it's going to be just as cool. But let's get on with today. Okay, so our weekly agenda is right here. Okay, the weekly agenda is a little different for some of you. So take a look. If you are on Mobi Max, right here, there are other tabs that you can definitely go check out. There's math, there's letters, there's reading. There's all sorts of cool stuff up there in Mobi Max. But must-dos, you must go to Seesaw. You must do your PE and your writing assignment. They're in there. There are some other assignments in there as well you could do. You must do your exit ticket. Got to say kind of what you already knew before you started the week, what you learned, and then what you would like to learn about. You're here at the morning meeting, so thanks for joining me. One more video. You're going to have to check out some of those videos. There's a lot of other things I was looking at when I was going to YouTube. There's tons of videos up there, guys, with math games, money games, all sorts of really cool stuff. Get up there and check out a couple more videos. If you had Zoom meetings, we're only going to do Zoom meetings for the next two Fridays. And then our last one will be Thursday, June 4th at 9:30. I'll be coming to see you if you feel it safe, parents. I'm going to come see a little 6 foot away meet and greet just to make sure we've checked in on everybody, how they're feeling, kind of where they're at for the end of the year notes, so to speak. Okay, so we're at Thursday. Let's get going. Our morning meeting. So today is Thursday, May 21st already, 2020. We're going to do our morning meeting. Reading passage, weather. Remember, get up there in those epic books. We've already checked some levels. Don't forget, we have prizes going out to students who are reading and taking those little question tests at the end. If you are doing AR tests and you're almost close, I think Miss Brittany was going to call either today or tomorrow and just let you know if you have books. We'll do a congratulations out to one student who's completed what was needed. A couple other ones, get up there and get those books completed so you can get your medal. Videos, videos, videos. We just talked about that. Get up there and watch some of those other videos. Keep all of your learning skills right where they need to be. That way when school comes back in session or if you're going to summer session, it's not going to be too tricky. Keep doing that. Tomorrow, I'm going to be picking up the All About Me poster, so it should be all about you, giving us information about what you like, what you don't like. And also on Seesaw, there was something that you could, a little page you could do that tells about you and what you think other people think about you. So if you could do those, that'd be awesome. I'll be picking up those tomorrow, as well as senior posters. Remember the owl, you cut him out, color, glue him onto the paper I gave you with some really awesome kind words. Library books. Up on Dojo, I put a few people who are still needing to turn in some library books. So if you have those at home, please have them ready for when I pick them up tomorrow. All right, let's get on to our meeting. You guys are really great about this because we're almost done with May. What number month is May? It is 5. Check your data on my board. What's today's number? It's right here. 21. And then the year. Right, we've agreed on doing 2020. If you only put 20, that's totally fine. All right, let's get rid of today's agenda. All right, so today's number goes right here. Now check your data, you just did it. All right, it is 21. And then we jump down and move all the way to the left. We're gonna green tab, or name it. Means we're gonna be thinking about it and then come back to it. So 21, if you know how to do either one of those words, put them in there. If you need to stop the video and do that, that's no big deal. Join us when you're ready over at Tally It. So we're gonna do left to right, just like we read. We're over here at Tally It. This may be a minute because that's a lot of tallying to do 21. Don't forget to make bundles of 5. And if you have any extras left over, go ahead and do that now. And I'll pause my video so we can move on. So go ahead and do that now, and I'll join you in a minute. Okay, welcome back everybody. So your Tally It should look something like mine. If it doesn't look like mine, recheck it. Recheck it, okay? You should have 4 bundles of 5 and then 1 left over. Okay, go ahead and jump on down over here to place it. And we're leaving, starting from left, and we move right. So over in place it, you're going to check your number, your today's number. How many ones, tens, or hundreds do you have in that number? Ones, tens, and hundreds. All right, you have 1, 1. There's 1 in the ones place. And 2 tens. Great job. See the tens place? What about the hundreds place? There are 0. There is 0 in the hundreds place. Okay, when you're finished there, go ahead and move over to frame it. And it seems like we get going a little bit faster, but you guys are so awesome at this. Now take your time with frame it. You're going to take this information and move it over into our frames. Remember, you're going to have 2 whole 10 groups and 1 left over. So go ahead and do that and join me when you're ready. Okay, welcome back. This is what your 10 frames should look like. It's asking you to do 2 whole groups of 10, and we've done that here, 1, 2. Then it says we have 1 left over, and we do 1 right there. I'll put this right below so we can do our frame of information when we're doing a fraction. So yesterday, we know we just had 2 whole groups, and that's not the case today. We're going to actually have to add a fraction. So how many whole groups do we have? Whole groups of 10. 2. Are there any more than 2? There are. There's something over here. So now we have to make a fraction. We have to do a numerator, which is a changing number, and a denominator, which is the size of the group. So what size group is our 10 frame? It's a 10 group. It's worth 10. There's 10 boxes here. It's worth 10. How many of the boxes are we using? We've only X'd out one, because we had one over here in the ones, so we added one here. So of our 10 frames today, we're using two whole 10 frames plus one piece or 1/10 of the other 10 frame. I'm telling you, fractions are really super fun. Okay, move this so we can jump on down to before and after. Remember, this belongs to you. If I put a 21 here, you need to find out what's after, what's before. You will need to be thinking about a number sentence. So take all your information from 21. How would you like to make your number sentence? But for now, we're going to go take care of this green tab up at Name It. Remember, 21 starts with that blender in the front, has a tw sound. TW, 20, NT. Now, some people might put an E there, but we know it's that tricky Y. And put a little dash, because we're going to add the next word, which is one of your sight words. If you do it with the W, that means you're winning the game, because you're talking about you won. They sound the same, but they are not spelled the same. Go ahead and finish that up. When you're ready, jump down over here to number sentence with us. You're going to jump all the way down and move all the way over to the right. Okay, you're responsible for one, so I'm going to do a little bit of a tricky one today. I'm thinking I want to do a little tricky one today. So down here at the bottom, we haven't done counting by twos for a while. So I'm going to pause my video. I'm going to make 21 tallies, and I'm going to show you how we're going to do this a little different. Okay? Okay, so at the bottom, I have 21 tallies. Now the difference is I tried to bundle them a little bit closer to groups of two. So when I say groups of, you know it's going to be a multiplication problem. And then I have this guy left over, so we're going to have to do something with him. So let's count how many groups of two we're going to have. There's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. How many groups of two do we have? We have 10 groups of, remember that's that multiplication sign, and how many is in each group? What do we have left over? Just one. Now, are we going to add it, subtract it, multiply it? We're going to add it because it's a leftover. It still has to go in the group. So if we were to count by twos, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, and 21. So we can do our number bond. We'll do it this way so I can write my number 20. Plus one more, it'll be 21. So either way you do these is 21. So you can put 20 plus one, or 10 groups of, or 10 times two plus one equals 21. All right. I think we're gonna head on to weather. So if you'll get your weather chart out and meet me right back here. All right, so we're on to weather. Now up here today is, and we could just write Thursday. You can just keep the day of the week going. You can write all the information that was on our other chart, which said today is Thursday, May 21st, 2020, with a period. And if I put today is Thursday, that is a sentence. That's all the information I'm gonna give you. It will have a period. Going down over here to weather report. It is 70. It's 70 degrees today, and it's supposed to get a lot warmer in the next couple days. So I'm excited. I can see the sun shining. It's a little bit warm outside already. And I can hear the birds, and I know there's lots of cool things we can be doing outside today. It is still spring. Summer falls on June 21st. If you're going to summer session, it's gonna be fun. We're gonna do something really cool. And then what does your weather look like today? So I know I hear lots of birds. I see the sun shining and it's quite warm outside. I do see a little bit of wind blowing my trees. So I could say it's sunny and windy. Period. That's all the information I'm going to give you. All right, go ahead and finish that up. And if you will get your reading passage, we'll finish that up today. And then we're on to talking about the U.S. mail. Go ahead and get your pencil, reading passage, and I'll see you in a minute. Okay, so here's our reading passage. And we are going to do a bumpy read, then a cruise read, and then finish all of the data that we need down here. Because we need to find some written information from up here to finish our statement. All right, here we go. Way back at the top, go to sentence number one. Now, if you learn some new words as you've been reading this, go ahead and underline them, dot them, so you know you can read it. And I'm just gonna go ahead and read with you, okay? Here we go. Sentence one. Searching on the shore. And remember, this one's a little tricky, but you just put it quiet there. This guy's gonna talk. There you go. So you might know that word next time. Number two, Mom found 5 round shells and I found 13 flat shells. Number three, how many shells did we find in all? Now these words up here, found and round, those are really tricky. We hadn't worked a whole lot on our ow sounds. So the O and the U, they do an ow sound, kind of like you're ripping off a band-aid, ow. Shells, I'm gonna use this one right here. Shells, remember it's an eh. These guys talk together, so it's no big deal. So shells should be a word that we can sound out with that blender in the front. And those devil owls talk together. So let's go on a cruise on this read. Ready? Here we go. Searching on the shore. Mom found 5 round shells and I found 13 flat shells. How many shells did we find in all? Great job reading, you guys. It can be tricky, just keep trying it. It's totally okay. That's where if you go up to those YouTube videos and you go to those sentence strips It helps you work through some of that reading a little quicker so we can be a cruise readers. Get up there on Epic Books. If you have some books read to you, you can hear the pace and the rhythm of the reading. And then maybe you can read it without it reading to you. It'd be pretty awesome. Get up there, challenge yourself today. All right, down here in the equation, we already said we did something up here. We just had to bring all this information down. So I said 5 plus 13, and I knew the information was 18. So we have to find out for our answer statement, the last information, sentence number 3, how many shells did we find in all? So you can put just the information if you wanted to. You can write just the information. But I know we've been doing a really great job all year of doing this, and we want to put the bigger information. So it's asking we. So we want to tell them how many shells we found. So here we go. We found 18 shells. Whoop. I was going to write another 8 on there. Silly. Now you can put, we found 18 shells, but they're asking in all. So we want to add that math information. Period. I know you guys kind of wondered why I started up here when I should be writing on the line, but I knew we were going to add extra information. If you write 18 shells, that answer is fine. Make sure you put the period. If you wrote, we found 18 shells, period, perfect. Some of you fourth and fifth graders, the information is complete when you use all of that math information. We found 18 shells in all. So before we get on with the rest of figuring out something about our mail today, I'm just going to flip my page over. I'm going to do a quick little odd and even for you. So I'm going to pause my video. I'm going to be right back, and we're going to do an odd even challenge. See you in a minute. Okay, so I have done this. I'm going to do odd versus even challenge. So right here, I'm just doing 1 to 10. So I tallied a 1, tallied a 2, a 3, a 4, all the way down here to a 10. So I'm going to pause the video. If you want to play the game along with me, go ahead and set up your paper and come back in a minute. Okay, if you're ready, here we go. So I might have to have the light on because I have a shadow. There, that might help me not have a big shadow. Okay, so here's how we play the game. If it's odd, there's always going to be someone without a partner because we're wrapping them up in twos. Everyone's going to partner up in twos. So you're going to know your number is odd if there's no partner. Okay, so let's check out that one tally. That one tally right here. Does he have a partner? He doesn't. So he's gonna equal O, O for odd. Now look at the number 2. Remember, you can only circle groups of 2 when we're doing odd and even. Let's try it. 1, 2, we can circle them. Is there anybody else in that row without a partner? No. So this will be E for even. Look down at number 3. K, Okay, you're going to circle groups of two. One, two, circle it. Is there anybody without a partner? Yes. So it is going to be odd, O for odd. Go down to your tallies of four. Circle groups of two, ready? One, two, circle it. One, two, circle it. Anybody left without a partner? Nope. E for even. Let's do our five. Ready? One, two. One, two. Anybody left over? Okay, go down to your six. There's two. There's two. There's two. Leftovers? Everyone's got a partner. Ready? There's two. There's two. There's two. Leftover? Yep, he's right there. Here we go. Partners, 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 and partners. Anybody left over? Nope. Next one. This is our nine group. There's two. There's two. There's two. There's two. Anybody left over? And down to your 10. There's two, 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 and two. Anybody left over? So when you're trying to figure out odd and even, everyone has to have a partner, so it needs to be groups of two. How I teach it in the classroom needs to be groups of two. And if anybody's left out, then it's going to be odd. If everyone is partnered up, it's going to be even. Now I want you to take a look at this. Look at the pattern. Every other one is odd. Every other one is even. So if you think about the pattern, it might be easy to kind of guess. So if you had the number four, which equals even, if I give you the number five, you're gonna know that he will be, check the pattern. There's four, what's gonna be five? Odd. So if you did this with rolling just one dice, rolling two dice, getting a number, maybe picking some numbers out of a basket, using some cards, you can do your odd and even game with a partner, with your family, by yourself. It'd be super fun. So if you were rolling dice and you rolled a five, it would be odd. If you're using two dice, maybe you rolled a nine. We already know nine is going to be odd. What if you rolled a 10? It would be even. So this would be a really super fun game to play. I might do a video on it. I just don't have my dice with me today. All right. So if you're not finished up with that, go ahead and finish up. I'm going to get the new video we need to watch on systems at work, all about the post office, how it works. Let me get all my things together. So get a clean piece of paper. We're going to write some information down, and then you're going to watch a video today on the U.S. post office. See you in a minute. Okay, everybody, welcome back. So I'm going to leave this here for a couple minutes, and I'll post it up on Dojo as well. This is going to be the next video that you watch. It's going to take you all through how a letter that you mail to me, or I've mailed to you, or that you receive all the time, how it gets to the post office, through the post office, and then where it's supposed to go. It's a really cool video. The best thing about it is my dad used to work for the post office, and I did for a little while, and inside of a post office is really busy. It's really loud, but it is so cool. So I hope you enjoy going to Systems at Work on YouTube. You type in Systems at Work. It won't say all about mail, but it's all about how that mail gets from you delivering it to where it's supposed to go. All right, I'm gonna post that up on Dojo when we're finished here. And yep, you see it. Truck. Truck is your word for today. That's usually how we get our mail now. Instead of by horse, it comes with the mail truck, a mail car. Usually it has one of those mail trucks that they have. Okay, I'll show you this word in before we leave again. All right, so you have your empty piece of paper, or you have your little sticky notes. However you need to do it. Set up your paper something like this. We already have your title. We're gonna do the same that we did for the Pony Express. We're gonna have all of our information. So after you watch the video, you're going to find, a setting. What's the setting? It could be the mailbox. It could be from your house to where it's supposed to go to. But what settings does the mail use? Are there any characters? So there's a couple of people that will tell you what their job is. It's really super cool. That would be some of the characters. There's your title right here in the middle. Are there any problems in this mail? If there were, are there any solutions to those problems? How did they fix it? What did they talk about? If they didn't give you a problem or solution, it's okay, you can leave these blank. Just know that there could be one of these here, but you need to have your title, your setting, some characters. Okay? Remember, there's our word again. You should be receiving, if you haven't already, this paper. You need to send it back. I have to have it in my mailbox. I highlighted it by June 1st. It needs to be in my mailbox. Don't send it on June 1st. You need to put it in the mail before that so it gets to my house on June 1st. So that's still about a week and a couple days away. You still have time. Remember, if you didn't receive this, you've got to get a hold of me because I have one left. I think everyone